Our society and our world are full of these invented and built up and contrived facades. And sometimes some people come along with a hammer and smash that facade. It's a brilliant, powerful hammer. It's a brilliant, powerful hammer to smash that facade. It's a brilliant, powerful hammer to smash that facade.
Welcome to the future. Shit where you please. The Wi-Fi's killer, but there's no more bees. So there's hardly any flowers, there are very few trees, and you'll pay $1,000 for some honey for your tea. But we got these awesome collars, mine's an Apple Model 3. It allows for better movement than the Tesla X Elite. It lets you customize the ads that it implants in every dream, and for premium subscribers, doesn't shock you in your sleep. But it doesn't stop there. It can analyze your speech, and if it hears disinformation, then it notifies police. It's a swift re-education, but it knocks you off your feet like your booster every seventh week. I faced the future boldly with two eager open eyes, and I picked a couple nuggets up that blew my fucking mind. Like, you can taxidermy someone while they're technically alive, and they'll shine when it's election time. See, the Democratic voter base will pay them zero, never mind if voting for the scarecrow is a vote along their party lines. They could stare into its marble eyes and claim there's something dignified. Unlike real politicians, this one doesn't need an oxygen or kid supply. But its function is the same as those who came before, the goals are never misaligned. It still spends all its working time performing pre-recorded fleecing sessions where it sugarcoats your slow and hungry genocide, while pouring billions into Nazi coffers, all the while selling you the story that we're moments till the MiGs arrive. So fuck it, ask Zelensky if he'll help replace our leaded pipes. Watch a fleet of Penskys show, stacks of bills in every size. Guess it only took a black sun and a couple Heils. Honorary goose step in some Nazi boots a quarter mile, all while Biden sneers his sordid smile. I don't know what was in this morning's vial, but it makes him stare 1,000 yards through all the prompters and the cards like he can smell the nearest child. His eyes are wide and wild, wider than the grave in which another 1,000 families were tossed in as I typed until they rose up to the sky unceremoniously piled. Which sort of flies right in the face of all this network ticker tape where the American economy has superhuman vitals.
And sometimes some people come along with a hammer.
See, I like to think my trial's gonna play like a recital. I'll denounce the world around me and accuse the most entitled, who weaponize their titles, whose pull is something tidal, who'd starve us all to death to best delight their blighted idol. So they might destroy the record, and I will never get to vinyl. So my word is not immortal, but it's final.
It's a brilliant, powerful hammer. It's a brilliant, powerful hammer to smash that facade.